But first, their job is your health. How public health inspectors check that the food you eat is safe.
We protect people's health by ensuring that the food that is served to the public comes from an approved source, that the food handling is done in a sanitary manner, and the premises and restaurants are kept in a sanitary condition. So there are a lot of different types of facilities that we do inspect. We inspect your full restaurants, we inspect bakeries, hospitals, daycares, long-term care facilities, chip trucks, ice cream trailers, anything basically that does serve food to the public, it will be inspected. As for the different levels of the inspections, there are high, medium, and low risk inspections, which means a high risk premise would be categorized as something that would get inspected 3 times a year. And what that means is that premise deals with high risk foods or has a lot of preparation steps or serves a high risk population, such as a hospital, immune compromised people. So medium risk means that they are inspected 2x a year and that they don't quite fit the category of a high risk premise, but they do deal with hazardous foods, but not as many preparation steps. So things like fast food and bakeries would fall into that category. And a low risk would be inspected 2x a year, and that means they basically just sell prepackaged foods. So things like a convenience store would be considered a low risk premise. So 2 or 3 common causes of foodborne illness are very, very preventable, and they're very common things that you might not think. Improper cooling, if things are cooled improperly, that means that they are being allowed to sit in a temperature where that bacteria can grow and will make people sick. For advanced preparation, it has to do kind of with the same thing. They're making things too far in advance and not storing them properly, and thus bacteria can grow and make people sick. And with an infected worker, it means that if people are sick and still coming to work and not washing their hands properly and then spreading their virus and germs to the public. So the next thing we are going to look at is the fridge temperatures and fridge storage. So we'll open the fridge here. So what we will take is we will use a laser thermometer, so this takes surface temperatures of the food products. So I'll take a temperature and we are good. So what we look for as a health inspector is there are certain temperatures that it needs to be in to make sure that bacteria will not grow to make people sick. What we also will look for is the storage of the foods here. So we want to make sure that the ready-to-eat foods are on the top and any raw foods are on the bottom to prevent any cross-contamination, which could also make people sick. And again, just also general cleanliness. So everything looks good here. So when food is being prepared or set out on the counter, we will take internal temperatures to ensure again that it is at the proper temperature so bacteria won't grow and people will not get sick. So we have a yogurt here. Here's my probe thermometer, turn it on. Take an internal temperature and it's good. So we want to make sure that hot things are kept hot and cold things are kept cold. In many kitchen facilities, there are equipment such as meat slicers and other things that can't be moved to a sink to be cleaned properly. So when we do inspect, we do make sure that the equipment is being cleaned in place and sanitized. So we'll look to make sure that's been taken apart. There's no dirt and debris left in there to make sure that they're doing that regularly. And another thing that we would look at is in their cupboards to ensure that there's pots and pans that are being stored properly. Make sure it's clean and to look to see if there's any evidence of pests, so mice, droppings, things like that. We want to make sure that there's none of those issues. So at the oven area, what inspector mainly looks for is cleanliness issues. So we would look at the exhaust hood to make sure there's not a lot of dirt and debris build up in there to prevent things from falling down into food that could be cooking here and potentially make people sick. We would look at the stove top, again, to make sure that there's not a lot of dirt and debris build up in here. We would look in the oven here, looking for cleanliness issues. Looks great. Below here, underneath in the floor area, we would check right underneath there to make sure that things are clean under there. And if there was food cooking on top of here, we would also take an internal temperature of anything that they would be cooking at this time. There are so many things that a health inspector does look at during their inspection, but the final thing we will be looking at today is how they wash their dishes. There are different methods that each restaurant and facility can use, but today we will be looking at the three compartment sink method. So in this method, the first sink is used for washing their dishes, the second sink is used for rinsing their dishes, and the final sink is used for sanitizing their dishes. This is the most important step because this ensures that any harmful bacteria that might be on those dishes will be killed and thus people will not be able to get sick. So it's extremely, extremely important that this sink is working and that they do have that sanitizer present. And the way we check that is we do have these test strips, and with these test strips, we can just dip it in the sink in the solution and ensure that there is a color change to make sure that that sanitizer solution is working properly. Thing we do to try to correct a problem is we always try to work with the operator through education and time frame. So if things need to be corrected, and if they're not immediate hazards, we will give them a time frame to work with. If things are immediate hazard, we deal with it right at that situation. We want that rectified right away because that means that the public is at risk to getting sick. If they don't concur with the timelines that we do give them, then we do have an option of issuing them a ticket. As for closing a restaurant, yes, we absolutely can close a restaurant, and situations that might occur is if there's a severe rodent infestation, a sewage backup, they have no running water, or severe unsanitary conditions.